Hello and welcome to this HOG4 tutorial, which takes a look at the use of the live key for selecting fixtures that are on stage. When I refer to a fixture as being on stage, this means that at least one of its parameters is currently being changed, either under playback or in an editor. On stage does not just mean having an intensity above 0%. A fixture can be considered to be on stage if, for example, it is playing back colour but with 0% intensity. Any fixture which is not on stage will be ignored by the live key. You can clearly see in the output window when a fixture is not on stage, as all of its parameter values will be grey. The simplest use of live is to just press live followed by enter. This will select all on-stage fixtures, so long as they have an intensity value that is not zero. Holding down the pig key whilst pressing live, followed by enter, will select all fixtures that are on stage, including those at 0% intensity. By applying a mask, the live key can really speed up fixture selection, allowing a more visual approach rather than constantly relying on remembering group and fixture numbers. Using this LightConverse visualization, I will give some examples of the use of the live key. Throughout these examples, I will use the highlight key to make my selections clearer on screen. I have already made a custom highlight palette, which puts the fixtures at full and yellow. So, first of all, to recap, I'll press live followed by enter. You can see that all of my on-stage fixtures have been selected which have an intensity above 0%. Fixtures 1 through 4 and 101 through 112 have not been selected because they are turned off. If I clear this selection and now hold pig whilst pressing live, followed by enter, then this time, in addition to the other on-stage fixtures, 101 through 112 have also been selected. However, 1 through 4 still have not been selected because they are not on stage. All of their parameters are at default, as you can see in the output window. I will now play a different cue to look at what selections are possible using intensity masks. Each row of the LED fixtures at the back are at a different intensity value. If I press live at 10 enter, then only fixtures outputting an intensity value of 10% will be selected. Once they're selected, I can change values in the editor as normal. So if I type live at 50 through 70 enter, followed by at 0 enter, then fixtures outputting intensity values within that range are first of all selected and then assigned a value of 0% in the editor. If I press live at 0 enter, note how multiple different fixture types are selected, as they still have parameters being played back from my cue. If I want to apply a group mask and select fixtures which are at 0% but just within that particular group, I would select my LED par group, then press slash live at 0 enter. If I now play a different cue to turn other fixtures back on, and only want to select the LED pars which are on, then I can type live slash and then select my group. In both cases, typing the group number rather than pressing it on the screen also works. I can also make a selection using a palette as a mask. So if I want to select all fixtures that are turned on and referencing the cyan palette, I can press live followed by cyan. I could now choose a different colour to make a change in the editor, for example, dark blue. This works with any palette, including effects, so if I was unsure of the fixture numbers or group of fixtures on the circular truss, I could press live, followed by the effect palette they're referencing. Finally, it is also possible to combine a group and a palette mask. So for example, if I want to select just the red lights from the sharpies on the floor trusses and make them cyan instead, then I just press my floor truss sharpie group followed by slash live red, which selects just those fixtures, followed by the cyan palette. In the next tutorial, we will take a look at the various options available to work across different pages. Thank you for watching.